Hello, everyone, and welcome to the stream. I am your host, Nessie, the captain of this ship. And today, because I've been asked to do this, and because this game was bought for me on PC, however, we can't get to work on PC, we're going to be playing KOTAR. In other words, Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. It's a very, very old game that has been around for a very long time, and apparently it's a really good game from what Zeta says. Hello, welcome to the chat, cutest puppy in the pack. Welcome to the chat, hello, hello. Welcome. I am Nessie, the host, and I'm going to be joined by the lovely Zeta, who is going to be voicing everything. We have had to do a clusterfuck, for lack of a better word, for this entire thing. I'm going to be interested to see how we're able to work around all this. I'm very interested in how this is going to work. I'm doing it on my Switch. So a lot of this is all Switch type stuff. That's kind of where it's coming from. Let me do some admin stuff and reveal. Goal amount is 1,000. Story amount is 614. Because that's what I saw. There we go. Let's get that updated. Gotta love it when things aren't updated. Anyways, let me bring in my lovely friend Zeta. Hello, Zeta.
Hello. Hello. Yes. Hello.
You'll be able to still annoy me with, like, sound alerts. You realize this, yeah. Right?
Yeah,
but oh, I'll be able to hear no. them too. You'll be able to hear them! That's right! Oh, I think I'm going to start streaming my Streamlabs from now on. Just to stop my admins and moderators from annoying the fuck out of me.
I put the idea in your head. No.
Yeah, I think from now on, I'm not angry. Why is it not picking up my voice? Good question. Why is it not picking up my voice? Microphone. Oh, because it's picking up the wrong one. Yeti Classic. There we go. Ha-ha. We got it to work. Minor technical difficulties. I kind of want you to be here, too. So, where the fuck are you, Zeta? Guest PNG. There we go. I don't know what this is. Not concerned. Let's move you, kind sir. And oh, that's not the right thing. Yep, it works. Let me cut off your legs again.
No!
So, there's a joke where I quite often will cut off Zeta's legs. We do a whatchamacallit. What do you call it? We do an improv session. There we go.
Yeah. Yeah.
And
you off my legs for the thumbnails. It's bleh.
It's kind of hilarious. I think it's funny.
Why am I tiny?
Because I don't have enough room. You're small boy today. Just put up with it, okay? I don't have enough space. God damn it. It's how it's gonna be. You're gonna be small. There we go. Fucking Christ.
You do know that I'm gonna be getting my revenge.
Oh yeah, I am fully aware. We're not doing game capture. We're doing a video capture device. There we go. Haha. I have figured out how to do this. Maybe. Let me double make sure it's covering all devices. That's what it needs. That's the audio device that needs to be taken. Holy fuck. There's so much setup when it comes to like audio stuff when it comes down to this thing. Anyway, this is my Switch. This is me. Let me grab this. The reason we're doing it this way is so that Zeta can read everything.
Yeah.
Can you see everything? Is everything fine?
I can see everything, yes.
Okay.
Everything seems to be fine.
Let's hope that everything stays fine. Can you guys hear things? That's the next bit. It's gonna be quiet.
I think we can hear everything, yeah.
Yep. Playing the game volume. I am, however, not gonna have it that loud. Because we make commentary. We do stupid commentary on this channel.
We use our collective brain cell.
Yeah, we have come to the realization that we share a brain cell, and it's funny.
Both of our brain cells have just merged into a singular collective.
For my purposes, we're going to increase the brightness. We're going to turn music down. As much as I love Star Wars music, why is music still playing? God damn it. Thank you for the host, Ionic.
Hi, Ionic.
We just now started the stream. We've only been playing for 12 minutes.
Technically, we haven't even been playing for that because we just launched
the game. I literally just launched the game. I like having sound effects down. Movie volume. What's movie volume?
Since this is an old game, the cutscenes aren't integrated into the same audio system.
Okay. I hope this won't blare your ears then. That's the hope. It is. And of course, there's no way to.
2003 games.
Yeah.
The story is worth it.
That's not correct. How do I? Oh, okay. Okay.
Don't go for auto level up. Don't.
Okay. Autosave, combat movement. Okay, new game.
Let's go.
Who do I play as? A skillful rogue that gets by on stealth and guile. An explorer most at home on the fringes of space. A battle-ready fighter with no equal in combat. So we can go soldier, scout, or scoundrel.
You get Jedi shit later. You get Jedi shit later.
Okay. I almost want to be a scoundrel.
That's fair. I like the scoundrel jacket.
I've been, like, really into, whatchamacallit. I've been into rogues lately. I've been playing a lot of rogues in D&D. attributes. The attributes of your character apply bonuses or penalties to everything from combat to skill checks to force powers. Check each attribute to see what aspects of gameplay it can affect.
You'll catch on to it pretty quickly. It's basically 3E.
I was about to say, yeah. This is very D&D-esque. So do we want to boost con? Because I'm notorious for like not having really high strength in con builds. I don't know why. Like, I like going high intel, high dex, and high charisma. That's the way I am with my builds, and I don't know why. So let's put some points into con. Let's sure put points into dex.
If you want to use lightsabers later, at least put a little bit into strength. Just as a heads up.
Thank you. I'm being dumb. Okay.
Ooh.
Ah! Okay. That's fine, because that's just a plus one modifier. Ooh. Boost my dex. Oh, it only lets me... So anything past that... Okay! Fuck me.
It's There's because you've got limited points to buy with.
Well, once you get past a plus two modifier, it costs 2 points per.
That slightly rings a bell. It has been a while since I played.
That reminds me of 3.5, so it doesn't surprise
me. It is based on 3. The system is based on 3.5.
This is going to take me a bit, guys. When I work with my 3.5 characters, it takes me forever to fucking make my characters because I have to fight with the points. 30 points, though, is not bad to put into, like, your builds.
The average.
I lower my con. Did you hear it?
I did not. No.
What? And I'm even streaming. Huh.
Weird.
Weird. Very odd.
Oh well.
Yeah. Oh well.
Means I could just annoy you.
You should have seen my eye roll right there. Whoops, I did not mean to do that.
Do
That's looking like the build. Skills. Each of your character's skills has a number associated with it. This is the skill rank, and determines how good the character is with that skill. When using a skill to perform an action, the rank is compared against the difficulty check, DC number. This is all standard D&D stuff. For example, to open up a lock with a DC of 15, take your skill rank in security plus your wisdom modifier plus a D20 roll. If the total is 15 or greater, the lock is open. Typical skill checks.
Yeah.
Ah. Okay. So I definitely want to put towards still. Definitely want to be aware. Definitely want to persuade.
I don't know how much you want me to backseat game here.
How? I'm okay with backseat gaming with you.
Yeah, okay. You get other party members that can cover other skills. The only one that you have to, that only your character can do, is persuasion. Like, you can't persuade with any other characters, only your own.
Okay, let me put more towards persuade.
Other skills can be covered by other party members.
Okay.
Hi, Galaxy.
Oh, hi, Galaxy. I don't need any in demolition. Some feats allow you to use special items like heavy armor or implants. Other feats modify saving throws and skill checks during the game. And some feats, power attack, are used during combat. Check the description for each detail on the specific feat. You have been granted the following feats this level. Armor proficiency light, in other words, we can wear light armor. And critical strike, which is always nice. One remaining.
One.
So I can either go up to medium armor.
Yes.
Or choose one that I don't have.
There's a full scroll down list for this one. There's more than what you just see.
Fucking information. Yes, I would be giving. Oh, there's so much. There's so much. Do I go double? No, I can wait on double. When I go to finally get my lightsaber. Kind of want to get this. Do we technically have a level 1 character?
Yes, you technically have a level 1 character.
Why the...
You've been pressing B.
Oh, does anyone remember anything? I think I had 12 there. I think I had my dex up to 15. I had my con up to 14. My intel up to 10. I think I had this up to 10. I think I had this up to 12. I must have had my strength up to 14. And I guess I put the rest in charisma.
I guess. I don't remember.
I don't think I had my wisdom. Yeah. There we go.
I'm well, Galaxy. How are you?
Okay, so I have to choose one I don't have. Okay, let's get to, how do I capitalize?
I don't know. It appears to be different on the Switch.
There we go.
On the PC, you just type it in. I am preparing to give the best text crawl reading I have ever given.
You can do this. No. Back. Okay, here we go. We have a 14, 15, 14, 12, 10, 12.
Okay, here we go.
My health points is 8. My armor is 14. I have a fortitude of 2, a reflex of 4, and a will of 0.
Yay.
I will tell you, this is like 3.5 / Pathfinder. Actually, you probably could play this in Pathfinder. I bet it's in Pathfinder.
A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, I am reading it, Nessie! Star Wars! Knights of the Old Republic. 4,000 years before the rise of the Galactic Empire, the Republic verges on collapse. Darth Malak, last surviving apprentice of the Dark Lord Revan, has unleashed an invincible Sith armada upon an unsuspecting galaxy. Crushing all resistance, Malak's War of Conquest has left the Jedi Order scattered and vulnerable, as countless knights fall in battle, and many more swear allegiance to the new Sith Master. In the skies above the outer rim world of Taris, a Jedi battle fleet engages the forces of Darth Malak in a desperate effort to halt the Sith's galactic domination.
We have to be serious about this, because I don't think we can be.
We don't have to be serious about this.
Can I have, like, sexual prowess in this game?
Hello, motherfucker.
Well,
oh, thank you for the follow, Slumberjack. We're playing a very old game.
Yes. 2003.
Oh, God. That's like 20 years old. Almost yes. 20 years old. Yeah. It'll be 20 years this coming year. I have no pants on. I don't have pants. Why don't I have pants on?
We've been ambushed by a Sith battle fleet.
Because you were sleeping with this clothes in the chest, okay?
We don't have much time.
I don't have pants on. Do I go with Who Are You or the Endar Spire? I think I'm going to go Endar Spire. Makes sense, right?
Did you fall out of your bunk and hit your head? The Endar Spire is the ship we're stationed on. This ship. You probably don't even know who I am, do you? I'm Trask Olgo, ensign with the Republic Fleet.
This guy gives very specific commands and wants to know if they updated him for the Switch's controls.
We have to find Bastila. We have to make sure she makes it off the ship
alive. Or if they just cut out the ones that reference.
Do I say, forget it, I'm looking after my own skin? Or do I say, who's Bastila? Or Bastia?
Bastila.
What? What did you pronounce it as?
Bastila. Bastila.
Bastila is the commanding
officer.
That
was pronounced
in
the game. Bastila.
Well, not an officer, like really, that.
But she's the one in charge
I
of this
like
mission.
Like that.
One of our primary duties is to guarantee her survival in the event of an enemy
I
attack.
I just don't.
You swore an oath just like everyone else on this mission. Now it's time to make good on that oath. I know all about your reputation. How you used to smuggle spice and blasters along the Corellian run. I guess the Republic figured since
like
they couldn't
drugs.
Catch you, they might as well hire you. And I'll admit, the Republic is in desperate need of someone with your kind of skills. Desperate enough to overlook your shady past. But now that you've
signed
on for this mission, you're part of the Republic fleet. And Bastila needs all troops at her side during
yes.
this attack.
Okay, let's go help Bastila.
So hurry up and grab your gear. You need to suit up so we can get out of here.
Okay. The active quest screens includes important information related to your ongoing adventures. Refer to this journal for hints and guidance throughout the game. Okay. I have an ass. Look at how I'm standing. Look at this. Okay, where's the chest?
Behind you.
Oh.
There. There's a circle.
Okay.
Clothes in there as well, I promise.
Okay, clothing. How, is that all? Was there? Okay.
Yeah.
How do just, I put on clothing?
I don't know the Switch's controls.
The Sith might already be boarding. Put your equipment on so we can get out of here.
How the fuck do I put them? Oh. By pressing the plus sign. Okay. Okay, this is how we do all that. Not me it's trying to figure out how to do this fucking thing.
It's okay. The gun symbol on the one more along. You can't equip from that screen, it's one more along, the gun symbol one.
Fucking Christ.
The story is worth it, I promise.
Okay, so I'm gonna put short sword in this. Can I not? Then I'm equipping blaster.
Okay, let's move out. We should stick together. You'll have.
Did you just stand there while I was putting my clothes on?
I didn't think of the implication. Of that.
Did you literally just stand there and watch me put my clothing on?
I've never.
Well, you just ran into my room with me in my underwear. Excuse me, sir.
I've never thought of the implications of him just standing there.
Because of the attack, this room is in lockdown. But don't worry.
Like, you're cute, don't get me wrong, but...
to unlock the door.
Fuck. Okay, because of the attack, this room is in lockdown, but don't worry. I've got override codes. I'll have to use you to unlock the door. Okay. R? What the fuck is R?
Don't know the switch's controls. I can't help you.
Our bumper.
Ah.
There we go.
Now that the door's open, you better take the lead again.
What?
This is Carthel Nassi. The Sith are threatening to overrun our position. We can't hold out long against their firepower.
I'm just gonna laugh at this game the whole time.
Contacted us on our portable communicators. He's one of the Republic's best pilots. He's seen more combat than the rest of the Endire Spire's crew put together. If he says,
I should have put my Star Wars song thingies points thingies.
And a copy of Karth's message in your electronic journal, just in case we get separated.
I should have. Okay, let's move out. I don't care. Beep 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 boop boop boop.
That door's locked.
Astromech droids 4,000 years before R2-D2.
Oh, come on. Turn.
There should be an easier way to do that within the controls that there is on every other way of playing this game.
How do I... Oh, that was the pause menu.
Open the door. You can do it. Go on.
Fuck. Security. There we go.
I really like the Sith soldier designs.
These Sith must be the advanced boarding party. For the Republic!
For the Republic!
Yes. Scroll through your attack menu, you'll see other options like the sniper shot.
I don't know how to do things right now.
Okay. Grenades! Yay!
I loot all bodies because I am a loot goblin. That is my thing. I think I need just swap to you, bitch. Come over here.
I don't think you need to use them for every single door.
Ah!
I love the shiny Sith soldier designs.
I'm not exactly sure how I did that. Don't ask me how. Like, I really don't. Oh, there's a metal box.
There is a metal box.
Metal box with shit in it.
There was also a metal chest, in that room.
Guess I got another sword.
Grenades!
Do I get to meet Darth Vader in this? No, this is before this is 4,000, Darth
Vader. Yeah, this is 4,000 years before the movies. You get to meet Darth Malakko. This is before even the rule of two.
Can you, not pause for me?
It automatically does it because you're supposed to, like, plan out your approach.
Well, how do I lock on?
On PC, you would just click on them. I don't know how it works for the Switch. This game was clearly not made for this. For the Switch.
I'm low on health.
Yeah.
How do I heal myself? Damn.
Med packs. Really?
Got a feeling that
don't waste them on Trask.
I wasn't going to. I was trying to loot goblin.
Loot goblin. That door's just janked.
Fucking janked door. I guess we're going this way.
Yeah.
It's a dark Jedi. This fight is too much for us. We better stay back. All we do is get in the way.
Oh, do I get my lightsaber yet? I want my lightsaber, bish!
Not yet.
That was one of the Jedi accompanying Bastila. Damn, we could have used her help.
Yes, thank you.
Now that must have hurt.
I get to pick up the lightsaber.
No, you don't.
No.
You don't.
Oh, it's so sad.
You'll get your lightsaber later. And even better, you don't even need to go to another planet to get it in purple once you've got your lightsaber.
Can I get a purple lightsaber?
Yeah, the planet where you get your lightsaber, you can get basically any of the crystal colors that are in the game. There's a couple extra steps to getting purple over the other colors, but you can get it.
Equip the melee weapon. Why can't I?
The game doesn't like it if you have a melee weapon and a ranged weapon at the same time.
I even hold it like a. Oh.
not here on the bridge. They must have retreated to the escape pods. We better head that way, too. The Sith want Bastila alive, but once she's off the ship, there's nothing stopping them from blasting the Endar Spire into galactic dust.
Yeah, thank you for telling me that, because, like... But I want... we gotta go out of here. We need to get gone.
You need to get all the loot first.
Because Loot Goblin!
Loot Goblin is more important than the galaxy.
Yeah. I'm assuming it's
going back to the game. Back into the cockpit. You're just going back the way you came.
Why do I have to go back to the cockpit? I need to go to the escapee pod.
There's another door. There's another door in that room. This is where you need Trask.
How do I level up?
Oh yeah, level up. Don't know the switch's what? Controls.
That's right. Okay, I figured it out.
Don't auto level up. Regular level up.
I got it. I got 4 points.
Yeah.
Dual wield?
If you want, yeah.
Yes.
Excellent. I'm not going to criticize your choices or guide you in any way.
You're just going to secretly question my plans. I need Trask.
Yeah, he needs to open the door.
I need food. I'm hungry. My tummy's growling.
Something behind here. Damn, another dark Jedi. I'll try to hold him off. You get to the escape pods. Go!
I don't think you're gonna hold off this Jedi. Yeah. Okay.
Some peace track. Killed by Darth Bandon.
Why is it locked?
Damn. So you don't go and follow him.
Why can't I go in through either door?
There's a third door. There's a...
Shh.
And that wasn't an angry, that is a... I have suddenly remembered the layout of this room.
There's a third door! God damn it, there's a third fucking door!
I've tracked your position through the Endar Spire's life support systems. Bastila's escape pod is away. You're the last surviving crew member on the Endar Spire. Now, I can't wait for you much longer. You have to get to the escape pods. But be careful. There's a Sith patrol just down the corridor. Use your stealth skill to sneak past him.
Beat the stealth. Just keep going. Just sneakity sneak.
What is it? Don't be suspicious.
You have to fight these two. A sneak attack. Aha.
Don't be suspicious.
Use the computer. Use the.
How do I do this?
Do the tutorial. So that's That's the room on the other side. Oh, you don't have enough spikes. There should be more spikes in the room. Log out. Look for chests. Oh, that unstealthed you.
That's annoying.
You did a sussy baka.
I did the sussiest of bakas. Thank you. Ow!
Be careful. There's a whole squad of
Galaxy has redeemed the Bracca Board.
Need to find some way to thin their numbers. Thank you. You could reprogram the damaged assault droid to help you. I need to get into my Twitter for that. To slice into the terminal. Use the Endar. I'm shocked that no one else got it.
Well, I'm not allowed to take it.
Yes, you're not allowed to. But I'm shocked that, like, no one else got it.
Slice the computer. Overload the power conduit. Do it.
I already did it.
The end. That.
Nice. I did a fun thing. I electrocuted some people.
They steal their money.
And everything, right? Yes.
You've made it just in time. There's only one active escape pod left. Come on, we can hide out on the planet below. I'm a soldier with the Republic, like you. We're the last two crew members left in the Endar Spire. Bastila's escape pod's already
gone.
He's
kind of cute.
There's no reason for us to stick around here and get shot by the Sith. Now, come on. There'll be time for questions later. Bastila's escape pod's already gone, so there's no reason for us to stick around here and get shot by the Sith. Now, come on! There'll be time for questions later.
I guess I go here.
In the escape pod, yeah.
Yep. Come join me in this escape pod. I did do the mass murder, Galaxy. Thank you.
Is it really mass murder if it's in the middle of a battle?
And if it's robots?
They're not robots.
Oh, they're not robots.
It's armor. It is armor.
Oh, I'm having a premonition.
Good to see you up instead of thrashing about in your sleep. You must have been having one hell of a nightmare. I was wondering if you were ever going to wake up. I'm Karth, one of the Republic soldiers from the Endar Spire. I was with you in the escape pod. Do you remember?
I had a strange dream, like a vision or something. Right, I'm Nessie Audios, by the way. How did we get here? Karth, the one on the communicator, I remember. What do I go with? Do I introduce myself? I don't think I'm gonna tell him about my dream.
We've been slipping in and out of consciousness for a couple of days now, so I imagine you're pretty confused about things. Try not to worry. We're safe. At least for the moment. We're in an abandoned apartment on the planet of Terrace. We were banged up pretty bad when our escape pod crashed, but luckily I wasn't seriously hurt. I was able to drag you away from our crash site and all the confusion, and I stumbled into this abandoned apartment. By the time the Sith arrived on the scene, we were long gone.
The Sith arrived. Oh, the Sith. The Sith? Question mark? We know what the Sith is. I guess I owe you my life. Thanks. Oh, there's more. I guess I owe you my life. Thanks.
You don't have to thank me. I've never abandoned anyone on a mission, and I'm not about to start now.
Terrace
is under Sith control. Their fleet is orbiting the planet. They've declared martial law, and they've imposed a planet-wide quarantine. But I've been in worse spots. I saw on your service records that you understand a remarkable number of alien languages. That's pretty rare in a world.
Because of the high intel. So, something to note about Pathfinder, which is Pathfinder and 3.5 are the same thing. If you put points into your intelligence, you learn a language for every point that you throw in there, on top of feats and on top of racial skills. So the thing is, with D&D 3.5 as well as Pathfinder, your race plays into your skills, while in normal 5e, it does not. It doesn't give you a lot of perks. You just, essentially, if you were to choose, like, say, elf, it's not going to give you many perks. It might give you some character flavor, like you can play a pompous asshole like you're from Skyrim, but overall, it's not going to give you anything. However, in Pathfinder, it does. So, keep that in mind.
Pathfinder, it does, but this is simplified, for the sake of making it a workable video game, you just know all the relevant languages.
But I figured I'd give some information on that. I like D&D, okay? I play a lot of Pathfinder, okay?
Yeah, I know you like D&D. I just thought I'd mention it just in case you were going to make any gameplay decisions based on it.
Oh, no. Yeah, Keywolf. I prefer playing Pathfinder over 5e. I started in D&D 3e, so when I say that D&D used to be very different and it was a lot of bullshit, my favorite by far is Pathfinder 1 next to 3.5. I have the most experience in 5e. I probably could create a 5e character by myself pretty quickly. And I'm about to play in a Pathfinder 2 campaign, which Pathfinder 2 is like 4E, the dreaded 4E. If you ever hear anyone talk about 4E, it's bad, because 4E was broken.
I've only ever played 5E, and that Pathfinder 2 campaign will be my first time playing any other system.
I'm not playing it on the D&D server.
You were talking about the one thing he was planning.
He is. It's going to be a bigger campaign on someplace else. Yeah.
Ah.
You're invited to that if you want to play a longer campaign. If you enjoy it, by all means, just, to reach out to me. I can get you in.
Just that I've only ever played 5e.
Yeah. So, Pathfinder 2 is not the way that you should be introduced to Pathfinder. I just want to recommend that. However, I do like the races in Pathfinder 2. I like how the races are set up. It's a lot more simple than Pathfinder 1. Anyways, I believe Bastilla was on one of the escape pods that crashed down here on Tartarus. I read that as Tartarus.
Yes, we are going into Greek mythology.
Yep. On Terrace, for the sake of the Republic war effort, we have to try to find her. How do we even know that Bastilla is even alive?
I don't, but Bastilla's young, and she has a powerful command of the Force. We survived the crash landing, so I'm willing to bet that she may have too. Besides, what's the
alternative? Watch, we find her dead corpse. She's dead. No one can stop
Malak and his Sith from wiping out the Republic, and I'd rather operate on the assumption that she survived.
She said that no one can stop Malak and his Sith from wiping out the Republic, And I'd rather operate on assumptions that she survived. How can one person, even a Jedi, be so important if Bastila Jedi, she can probably look after herself.
Bastila's gonna need her help. Many of Darth Malak's followers have mastered the dark side of the Force.
And dark
the
side of the
have
Force.
Already killed more than their share of Jedi in this war. I doubt anyone's specifically looking for us anymore. We're not that important. But if we're careful, we can move about the planet without attracting notice. A luxury Bastila won't have. She's gonna have half the Sith fleet looking for her. They know how vital she is.
Do I go text my dad to be like, hey, can you go pick me up a sandwich? She has a rare gift
the Jedi call battle meditation. Bastila's power can influence entire armies.
Worth a try.
I might. Can influence an entire armies. Battle meditation? If Bastila is so great, how come the Sith managed to blow up the entire Endar Spire?
Through the Force, Bastila can inspire her allies with confidence and make her enemies lose their will to fight. And often that's all it takes to tip the balance in a battle. But there are limits to what she can do. From what I understand of her ability, it requires great concentration and focus to maintain her battle meditation. The attack on the Endar Spire happened so fast, she probably never even had a chance to use her power. I'm guessing she barely got out alive, and now she's trapped here just as we are. The whole planet is under quarantine. No ships can land or take off. So if Bastila's gonna escape Terrace, she's gonna need our help, and we'll probably need hers.
Any idea where we should start looking for Bastila?
While you were out, I did some scouting around. There are reports of a couple escape pods crashing down into the Undercity. It's probably a good place to start. But the Undercity's a dangerous place.
So I have to go out. Prepared, and it won't is do what you're telling any me. Good if we go and okay.
Now you both go out. He's a party member.
Okay. Yay, I get the cutie.
You mind me spoiling slightly?
We can use this abandoned apartment as a base.
Huh?
We can probably get some.
Do you mind me doing a slight spoil?
Yes.
Just remember to keep a low
profile. He is the romance option for the female player.
Yes.
Can wipe away your memories and destroy your very identity. But I figure if we don't do anything stupid, we should be okay. I mean, after all, they're looking for bastards, not a couple of grunts like us.
I'm no Jedi. I can have a romance option, right? Karth, come here. Karth. Do I have to leave without him?
Yeah, you need to... This is sort of a hub until you get a ship. So this is where like the entire party will be, and you can take two party members with you.
I have to take Karth. I don't think it's much of a problem that I'm taking him. Sorry, I'm playing
Rot,
my rogue.
You alien scum. Everybody get up against the wall. This is a raid.
Oh shit.
That's how we sit.
The Sith Empire.
Got a lot.
Now the rest of you get up against the wall. Lovely before I people. Lose my temper.
Lovely
again.
People.
What's this? Humans hiding out with aliens? They're Republic fugitives. Attack!
I forgot. First time the Sith have come here and come to cause trouble for us, but hopefully it will be the last. I'm gonna say I'm glad I could help. Don't worry about the bodies. I will move them so it looks like they were killed elsewhere. Why am I the one reading?
If you wanted, you could have asked.
You were supposed to read the text.
I only said the text crawl. Hi, Puck.
I might be losing my shit.
I only sent the text crawl, but if you would ask to read the rest of it.
Can I open this?
On it.
You should be able to. With enough skill, I guess.
Who are you? What are you doing in here? You can't just come barging into someone's home. That's no excuse. You can't just go around barging into people's apartments because you're curious.
I'm just looking.
But at least you're more polite than that pig Holden.
Holden? Who's that?
Just one of Darvik's men who can't keep his hands to himself. But all he got for his trouble was a nasty scar from my vibroblade. Too bad I'm the one still paying the price.
What do you mean?
I don't want to talk about it. I'm in enough trouble already. Besides, I don't know if I can trust you.
I kind of want to persuade.
Well, I suppose you.
Oh, I succeeded! Right,
when I
the DC was low.
It made him back off, but it also embarrassed him in front of his friends. Holden's a spiteful little hut slug. He went and put out a bounty on my head for what I did. That's why I'm hiding out here.
Is there anything I can do to help?
Holden is one of Darvik's men. When you work for the local crime lord, the authorities tend to turn
a blind eye. Am I getting a side mission here?
I'm afraid this is between me and Holden now.
Yes, you are. That this game has plenty of side missions.
You could try, I guess. He usually hangs out at the cantina in the lower city. It probably won't do any good. Holden's used to getting his own way. That's one of the fringe benefits of being a goon for Darvik. Working for the local crime lord lets you get away with things. Still, I appreciate the offer.
I'll be going.
Goodbye
here.
And good luck. I hope you can talk some sense into Holden.
I'll try. Can't promise. Okay.
Tong haidwam jiji jum blumpa. Nita poe tikito. Dolpa da bongwaleo gandona chuchut. Kachi chu ita dundonga. Yuma lita kuta tun. Jilamulane nindu bobo. Wonga kumbis jang ba mulira.
Larum. Pleased to meet you, Larum. My name is Nessie Adios.
Runda di hotonga kun hunkabi.
Very high tech. Why does this guy make me feel like he's like a traveling salesman type of guy?
Because he is.
Okay. What's so great about these energy shields?
Use one that surrounds you with a radiant aura particle mesh that absorbs blaster bolts. Pretty handy in a fight. The shield even protects against lightsabers, or so I hear. Shields aren't perfect, of course. They can only absorb so much energy damage before they burn out. And ion blasters will take your basic dueling shield down pretty quick.
And I can tell you from experience that they aren't any good at all against.
And I can tell from experience they aren't any good at all against a simple vibroblade. That's why the Republic has been training soldiers in hand-to-hand and melee combat.
Where did this technology come from?
You're just choosing these options to get revenge. I've heard rumors of the Achani using shields like this, but I never saw anything like them around here. Not until the Sith came. Where they discovered the technology is anybody's guess. The shields are too rare and too expensive to hand out to an entire army, but a shielded strike team can take out a whole battalion of soldiers armed with conventional blasters. It gave the Sith a huge edge in the early battles, but it wasn't long before the Republic was able to copy the technology and come up with energy shields of their own. Now both sides are scrambling to come up with new weapons to slice right through the shields, but until they do, you're going to see melee combat coming back to the forefront in this war. Oh, okay then. Well then, You might be interested in knowing I have one for sale. It isn't cheap, but it could be the difference between life and death. You want to see what I have in stock? I know my kiosk isn't much to look at, but my prices are reasonable and the merchandise is sound. Okay.
Why do you have a kiosk set up there?
I run a little shop here in this old building, selling basic equipment to the illegal aliens renting out these apartments.
Mentioned something about illegal aliens?
By law, most aliens aren't allowed to have a residence in the upper city of Taurus. They allow a few of us Twi'leks up here, but for the most part, it's humans only. No self-respecting upper city human would want to live in the apartments in this dump. So the landlord has been renting out apartments illegally to aliens. Better than letting them sit empty, I guess. Otherwise, you get squatters and people hiding out from the authorities living in the abandoned apartments, and they don't pay rent.
Aren't you worried about getting caught?
The Taurus authorities pretty much turned a blind eye to this place. A few illegal aliens just aren't worth the bother. And once the Sith took over, they felt the same way. Besides, I don't live here myself. I just run a small business providing supplies to the residents. You want to see what I have in stock?
See what you got for sale.
No problem. Just step on up and have a peek.
So this is what he has?
Yep, that's his stock. Armor, computer spike, parts, that sort of thing.
I don't have a lot. Let's sell some shit, because we're not selling our repair kit, of course. Do we need the prototype?
How much damage does it do versus the regular type? The regular one? Nah, that's exactly the right. It's a +1 damage bonus over
physical.
Over the sell the regular ones. The prototype is slightly better.
I'm gonna sell one of the short swords. Sell two of those. Okay.
202 credits. Hello, Mr. Gunny.
Hello, Mr. Gunny. Welcome to the chat. Sorry, I am hyper-focused right now on trying to sell shit. Increased against droid. Does 1-4 damage. This is 1-8 damage. This does 1-6 damage. I feel like I should sell this and keep these two. Anyone disagreeing with that? The ion blaster is pretty decent.
I allowed to.
You want to comment?
I can't. I'm pretty sure I'm okay with it, but I don't remember if this includes the parties currently selected stuff in there. You should be fine, though, if you're using a sword and Karf is using a gun.
Maybe I won't right now until we figure out. Okay. Show by list. Okay, so I have a combat suit on currently. 4 defense bonus, 5 dex. So here I would get an increase in defense, but I would take a hit to my dex.
You can't afford it at the moment.
Oh, I can't even afford it. Fuck me.
I find it absolutely hilarious that this game introduced regular swords to the Star Wars universe because it didn't want you to have a lightsaber too early.
Come in.
Hmm?
You willing to do? I'm in a stream. That's why I was just gonna give you a note. Would you take a note? Okay.
All right, entertain everyone.
Entertain people.
I know.
Do not read the back of the fucking.
That's only to annoy you. That's only to annoy you. So, the back of Doctor Who DVDs. And now it's... Oh. I know what happens in this game. I know the story. And if any of you spoil that certain thing that happens, if you have played the game, you know the thing.
Chili pulled pork. Chips, no pickle or onion, iced chai with light ice and lavender cold foam.
Oh.
Is that all I want? Is that all I want, Zeta?
What do you want? Why did you say my name?
I was just trying to figure this out.
So, in D&D, defense isn't a stat, Galaxy. It's, dexterity is, how does one explain what dexterity is? Dexterity covers things like ranged damage, like precision weapons, acrobatics, that kind of thing. Defense isn't a stat in D&D. Defense, as a concept, would be covered by a constitution, which determines like your health points, your health points and stuff like that. Somebody once told me the world's gonna bone me.
I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. I'm back. Okay, let's go. Back. Oh, hi, hello, James.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm doing good.
On it. We are playing a game.
I can see that. I see Wheezy McSneezy is still here. In all of his glory.
Yep.
Of course. Should I just continue on? Probably should just continue.
You know, my payday, I'm getting that shirt, right? I'm gonna have it made for me. Just Wheezy McSneezy.
Can I get one?
Maybe. I'll think about it.
Okay. We need to get one each for the team, because it's the team mascot shirt, remember?
Yeah.
Wheezy McSneezy.
Oh, we've come around. Okay. Where do I go? I don't know where to go.
Keep running around in circles.
Yes. She is just running around in circles.
Aha! Found it. Shut up. I didn't know which way to go.
Would you play Knights of the Old Republic?
On my Switch.
Jeez. Why are you playing on the Switch? It's on PC.
Because we can't get it to stream.
I don't know, Puck. Why does Princess Leia style her hair into space buns? I know this is the setup for a pun. I know this is the setup for a pun.
Do it, Puck. Puns and
buns. Do the pun. Do the pun, Puck. Do it. So it doesn't hang solo. Solo.
I give up. Look, I got awesome dual pistols.
Yeah.
I don't know where I'm going.
That was extremely cringe.
You're cringe.
Oh my god.
I'm assuming this is where I go.
The medical facility.
I don't think that's where I go. Athena! Fuck off.
Just experiment.
Wow. Yavik says you missed your
aren't
last
you just
payment.
Athena?
Why does this guy look familiar?
A witch guy.
I've got 50 credits.
The black guy.
That should buy me some time, right?
Sorry.
That guy. He looks like a he looks like a more recent
but I don't
character.
Have that much. How can I give you credits I don't have?
You're a recent character.
It's too bad.
No,
Davik's gonna
help.
Kill
somebody
yeah, Davik's gonna be.
Somebody help! They're gonna kill me!
Careful about drawing attention to ourselves, but are we gonna just let them drag this guy off? Hold on a second. Looks like we got ourselves a witness here.
You can just say sorry, I'm going now, and leave him.
But.
But you'll feel bad about it.
Yes! Athena, do you want... What the fuck do you want, Cat?
Okay.
My cat is driving me insane. Butt is in the way. How the fuck am I supposed to get you a spot if your butt is in the way? Child! Fuck off.
That's not the cat's problem. That's your problem, Messy.
Apparently it's my problem. There you go. Are you happy now? You have space. Are you happy?
No. No. How dare you assume I'd be happy?
There you go.
I love that Boxy's voice is the cat.
Because he is a cat.
How dare you?
I almost feel like I don't like your attitude. I better teach you a lesson.
Wow.
Or do I take the more leave this man alone or you'll have to deal with me? Yeah. My cat is no longer looking at me.
Guess we'll have to teach you to mind your own business.
Yeah.
Get him, boys.
Oh, that's not my one.
How do you like that?
I owe you like save points.
Oh, he took care of it for me.
No, I can't pay him back. It's not good to owe a crime lord money. He'll just keep sending more bounty hunters after me till I'm dead.
Maybe I can help you.
You already helped me by saving me.
You can switch it around to just robbing him with one of the dialogue options. There's nothing else you can
do. Do I give him 100 credits?
Hand over all your credits if you want to live. What does Han say when Chewie messes up at something new?
I'll give him 100 credits.
Just like that? I don't know what to say. Thank you. Thank you.
You're giving him 100 credits? Generous.
I want this guy to like me, okay?
I'd better take these credits.
If he is a possible love option, I'm going to make him a possible love option.
Mistake. Light side points gained.
Ooh. Oh, I leveled up.
Yes.
Dope. Oh, cards. I'm just a bad person at this point. I'm gonna put one point into each of these.
Do you really gain like save points if you're just doing it to seduce guys? The game said you got no like save points, but did you really?
I don't know where I'm heading. I don't know where I'm going. This is bad. It's like the dumb leading the dumber at this point. That's kind of where I'm at, and I don't know. I don't know. Do I steal a speeder?
You can't, unfortunately.
Something's bothering him.
Yes, what's on your mind?
I'd like to know some more about you, Karth.
Me? Well, I've been a star pilot for the Republic for years. So more than two,
I was about to say, he's BB hungry! I love you, Puck! Thank you!
And the Mandalorians were that senseless. My homeworld was one of the first planets to fall to Malak's fleet. The Sith bombed it into submission, and there wasn't a damn thing that like Republic forces could do to stop them.
You're talking like it's your fault, like you failed somehow. I'm sorry, Karth, this must be very painful for you.
I'm just a soldier. I go where the fleet admirals tell me to. I follow my orders and I do my duty. It's just... doesn't seem right that doing that means I failed them. I didn't.
Them? Do you mean the people of your... I don't want to upset him. Oh no, what do I do? This is morally problematic. Ah, fuck. I'm gonna have to say I'm so sorry, Kurth. I didn't mean to upset you.
No, I know. Don't worry about it. I must not be making much sense. You probably mean well with your questions. I'm just not accustomed to talking about my past very much. At all, actually. I'm more used to taking action. Keeping my mind focused on the...
I know! So let's just get so sad.
If you have more questions, ask them later. Yes, what's on your mind?
Do you know anything about this place?
The planet's all one big city, but its golden years are long past, and things have gotten worse since the Sith occupied it. From what I hear, the wealthy live on the tops of all the tall towers, and if you're poor, you live down in the shadows, and it gets worse the lower you go. Well, that's all I can think of, at any rate. You got it.
It is basically discount Coruscant.
Oh, nice.
I don't know where I'm going.
Yeah, just explore around and you'll figure it out.
Can I take these things?
No.
God damn it. I just want to fly a ship. Oh, Karth.
He's wall-pinned you.
Karth. Excuse me, sir.
What?
This has gone to full debauchery at this point. Oh, military base. Am I supposed to go to the military base?
Will they let you in?
Probably not. I feel like that's a bad option. Aren't I supposed to get, like, to the Undercity?
That is indeed where Karth said the escape pod crashed.
I'm here.
Uh-huh.
What?
Fuck. Maybe it's this way? Droid shop. No, that's
the evil walks among us. The enemy is here. We must act now before we are overrun with the vermin invaders.
You're close. I'll tell you that you're basically close.
Why does that voice actor sound familiar?
This box infects our society. Listen to me, people. There is a terrible scourge sweeping our planet.
What did he voice act in?
It is too late.
What, this...
The evil walks among us. The enemy is here. We must act now before we are overrun with the vermin invaders.
Is it Alfred?
A plague.
No, it's Quincy Sharp.
We cannot sit idly by.
That's who it is. It's Quincy Sharp. From Batman Arkham.
Listen to me, people. There is a terrible scourge sweeping our planet.
He is playing a fanatic in so many games.
The evil walks among us. The enemy is here. We must act now, but friends and fellow humans, I'd bring you a warning. A warning of a great plague spreading across our planet.
Yep, that,
listen to
it's
me.
Quincy Adam, or Quincy Sharp. Blue. Yeah, I was like, wait a second, he sounds familiar.
We have to stop the spread of vermin scum throughout
Aris. Yeah. Vermin scum? What are you talking about?
I am speaking of the hideous-looking aliens who walk the world.
He voices a few characters in this game.
He's done a lot. I know that for a fact. I know he has quite an extensive repertoire.
have formed the anti-alien
Gorton
League.
Kolu.
The time has come for action. We cannot
anti-alien
sit idly
league.
By while aliens blight our glorious planet.
I don't know which one's worse. Your hate mongering or your ignorance.
You are like all the rest. You will not see the truth.
Because that's how I would see it. I'm like,
you will suffer with the rest of the alien lovers.
Come on, we should keep moving. Kook or no, people like him can make trouble for us.
I agree. Was that all I had to do with him?
A plague spreads through our streets.
It's a side interaction, not even a side quest.
Sith patrols and those with proper authorization are allowed into the lower city. It's obvious from the way you're dressed that you're not one of the Sith patrols, so unless you have the authorization papers, you must move along. If you were supposed to have them, you'd know where to get them. Now quit wasting my time and move along.
And that is indeed the elevator to the lower city.
Okay. So I need to go to the military base, is what you're telling me.
There are a number of ways you can get a disguise.
You're telling me. Could I sneak past him?
No, you can't sneak past him.
Fuck.
On it. Damn.
Impossible. Okay.
There are easier ways than raiding a military base to get a disguise.
Okay.
Keep in mind, a military base is a military base.
Can I kill the guy?
In broad daylight?
Yes. Okay,
Listen to me, people. There is a terrible scourge sweeping our planet. Heed my warning before it is too late.
I need an outfit like this.
Yeah, the Sith warrior armor, which I love the design of.
How the fuck am I gonna get an outfit from him?
What is this planet coming to, huh? Shlomi's just walking around
drunk.
The upper city.
Shouldn't you go to Laura says you belong, Shlomi?
Well, this is rich.
Yeah, like he said. These streets are for upper city citizens. You better get out of the way if you know what's good for you.
You'd better think twice about what you're doing. This might be more than you can handle. Yeah, Dad? Oh, thank you. Open the door. Sweet.
I hear that your sandwich has arrived.
Oh, I just put down there that it could be any, so. Yeah. Excuse me, cat? Can you fuck off?
Is this the cat trying to steal your sandwich?
Yes!
Foxy, voice the cat trying to steal Messi's.
What do you mean, fuck off? I'll have you know, peasant, that cat, that sandwich is mine. Hand it over now.
I'm happy now.
How dare you make sounds like that towards me? I'll claw your eyes out if you carry on.
Do I make friends with them? or do I get mean to them?
Do you want light side points or dark side points?
I'm gonna go light side.
Hey, for a slummy, you ain't so bad. Come on, boys, this slummy's buying the next round.
All my money's gone.
No way, forget it. No more drinks. We're late enough as it is.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Maybe next time, slummy. Come on, fellas, let's go.
Was that literally just a side thing?
Yeah.
Fucking Christ. Well, I can see how I get light side points. Yeah. I just want him to like me. How the fuck do I get?
Should I put you out of your misery?
Yes.
That there's a cantina somewhere. Visit it.
Oh my god, do I get someone drunk? Oh my god.
You do a bit better than getting someone drunk.
I'm assuming it's in the south. I need to find this cantina.
I don't remember which side it's on.
Fuck.
You missed loot.
Well, at least I got some credits. That's medical facility.
The high class upper city cantina, not the dregs of tattoos.
Am I full of myself? This looks like a cantina. What was it? Yeah, cantina. Ha
ha.
Do I drug someone?
We'll see.
My sandwich. Mm-mm. 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 Do I get to woo a soldier?
Just talk to people and find out.
You aren't from Terrace, are you? Do yourself a favor and stay away from the Teresian air.
It's a named character, not a generic person.
If you're here to complain about the quarantine, don't waste your breath. There's nothing I can do about it. I just follow the orders I'm given.
Yes, fuck the puns. You're
where
looking
you
in all the wrong places.
A trash compactor in the lower city? And where are those drinks we ordered?
Did you drop something?
Maybe.
I get the feeling this spoiled brat could cause us more trouble than she's worth.
Why is the help here so incompetent? One word from Daddy and I could get you fired. That's better. Now, hurry up with our order.
And here are your drinks, Miss Lavin. I apologize for the delay.
That's not the person I'm looking for.
Oh, I can't believe we couldn't get arena tickets for this match. Now we'll have to watch the duel on the view screen.
Who cares? It's Duncan and Gerlon fighting. It's not like we're gonna miss anything good.
Shh, they're about to start, so quit complaining and just watch the view screen.
Ladies and gentlemen, I draw your attention to the dueling ring. Here, two combatants will battle for your viewing and gambling enjoyment. Now, I hope all your bets are down because we're ready to roll. In this corner, I give you Gerlon Two-Fingers. And over here, looking to climb the ranks yet again, is the ever-persistent Deadeye Duncan. And to nobody's great surprise, Deadeye is down again. Don't worry, folks. He's Rick. Just unconscious. As usual, our medics will have him up and about in a bit. Well, that was quick, wasn't it? So I give you the winner, Gerlon Two Fingers.
So sad.
The duel arena is a side thing, but if you want to get a few levels, it's good.
I haven't seen you around here before. You looking to step into the duel ring? Or did you just come to watch?
Ah! That was okay. What happened to that?
What? Why are you here if you don't even know what the dueling ring is? I don't have time to answer your questions. I need to stay focused for my next match. Maybe Azure can help you out. He's the hut over there in the corner. He arranges all the duels.
Well. I don't think any of those are it.
Yep.
Hello there, youngster. You interested in buying the Pazak deck of an old man looking to get out of the gambling game? Just 50 credits and I'll sell you all my cards. I'll even throw in a free lesson to boot. It's a great deal, if you can afford it. Don't get me wrong. The game's been good to me over the years. I've traveled the span of the galaxy.
My favorite side quest.
Worlds to the farthest reaches
my
of the
favorite
outer
side activity, I should
I've
say.
I've won countless fortunes and lost countless more. But that was long ago. Things have changed. Gambling is a young man's game. That's why I'm looking to get out. My offer still stands. 50 credits gets you my old Pazak deck. And a free lesson. A great offer if you can afford it.
I am pulling onions off my sandwich that I asked for no onions on.
Aww.
Allergic to onions. It kind of is a trouble if there's onions on my sandwich. I even put like on the note, no onions
on my sandwich. Ogres. I like onions.
I'm better.
Of course.
Oh, I should have.
Hello there, young. Just
I'm gonna buy him.
Glad to see you're interested in the grand old game. The rules are pretty simple. Here, I'll load them up into your data pad so you can check them out anytime you want. Good luck. I hope the game's as good to you as it was to me. Now, is there anything else I can do for you?
I'd like a lesson. Basic deck has two numbered 1 through 5 available to create a side deck. You will find other side deck cards as you play the Knights of the Old Republic. Values from negative 1 to negative or plus to 6. Okay. Select 10 cards to form your side deck now.
You only have 10 cards to choose from, but...
The object of the game is to face, have your face-up cards total higher than your opponent's hand without exceeding 20. So, it's essentially...
Blackjack. It's blackjack, but you have minus cards, and you can also add in your hand whenever you want.
Your hand... Your total is over. Draw.
It's blackjack with extra steps.
Yeah.
And also the AI cheats most of the time in the game.
Damn it. I don't have a negative card.
No, you don't. The second game did a better job at balancing the Pazak AI.
God damn it. Complete bust. So sad.
Leave me alone. I'm not giving out any auto prints to my fans today. What? You don't recognize me? I'm Bendix Starkiller, the most famous blaster slinger on Taras. Over 100 duels without a loss. Every one of them a deathmatch.
I'm watching this, knowing who you have to talk to. I'm seeing you just completely
miss them. Now. Once deathmatches became illegal, I just got bored with the game. I got no interest in using stun blasters. There was nobody left to challenge me anyway. I've been watching these new kids in the ring, but I haven't found anyone worth my notice so far. Still, if someone could beat all these other pretenders, I might give them a shot. Good luck with that, kid. You're gonna need it.
You sure you want to get involved in this? Seems a bit pointless to me. Up to you.
Okay. I'll give you a hint and say that it's a woman.
Don't you just love watching the Pazok players? All that strategy, all those credits. It's enough to make a girl get all flushed.
Sorry, but I'm not here looking for conversation. I just came to get a drink, listen to some music, and try to relax before my next shift at the military base. I don't wear my uniform when I'm off duty. It's not allowed. In fact, anyone in uniform is banned from entering the cantina. The officers don't even like it when we show up here off duty. Don't like us fraternizing with the locals, I guess. But it gets pretty stale hanging around the base all the time. Besides, the Sith don't own me. Being a soldier in their fleet is just a job, you know. A job with long hours and low pay, I might add. When I signed up, I was promised adventure and excitement in exotic locales. Instead, I end up stationed at a military base on some backwater planet on the fringes of the galaxy. If I could just find some other way to earn some credits, I could give this lousy job up. Retire my uniform, so to speak. What? Are you offering me a bribe? You realize this is treason, right? If I report you, the Sith will have you executed.
You report me and I tell them how you really feel about your job. Or I don't think you'll report me. I think you've been waiting for an offer like this.
The truth is, I find your offer rather tempting. I could probably get you some uniforms. But if we get caught, we're dead. You're asking me to take an awful risk. If I'm going to do this, it's going to cost you. 200 credits up front if you want some uniforms.
I went the boring way. That there's a route where you can get her to invite you to a party. And you just drug the entire party and steal the uniforms. You have went the boring route.
Hmm. 100 credits is a small fortune. I'll never have the chance to make that much in one shot.
I have gone the boring route because
okay,
I fear.
The trick is to get you the uniforms without the
Sith knowing. You don't want to upset Karth.
I'm going to a party with some of the other Sith soldiers tonight. You show up, and I'll make sure everyone else gets
my
sexy
man.
When we pass out, you can take our uniforms. I'll probably get a reprimand for not locking it up, but that's about it. Then, in another month, I'll resign and retire with all those credits you gave me. Here, I'll add the address of the party to your datapad. Show up there later. To be on the safe side, we shouldn't speak again, before or after the party. I'll go make all the arrangements.
Well, you get the party anyway.
Party tonight. Just remember,
you just don't get to drug
get
them.
With those uniforms, I don't know you.
So do I follow her?
It's in one of the apartment thingies. There's two sets of apartment thingies, one on each side of the city. I don't remember which one it is.
Fuck. Okay.
So that you're just gonna have to break. You're just gonna have to break into every apartment. That is correct, Galaxy. Credits is magical space money that is exactly as much worth as it is.
So I have to find these apartments.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. South apartments. Here we go.
Break into every single one.
On it. Done.
That's not the right one.
What, you already opened? No, that's not even one. That's a closed one.
On it. Done.
Hmm.
Hmm. There's stuff there. Do you steal the stuff?
Will it get me negative?
It won't.
Not hers.
Okay, it might be in the other set of apartments in the northern city.
Yeah. Fuck. There's no fast traveling, is there?
No.
Fuck. I don't know why I went this direction. I went around that thing. I don't know why.
It's the journey, not the destination. Galaxy, you won't find an example of how much one credit is to real-world currency because items in video games have different supply-demand curves than real-life stuff. That's why a magic medical potion in Pokemon costs less than a bottle of water.
Nope.
I think it is that room, so maybe there's something you need to do first. Can you check the quest log thingy? I might be forgetting something. One more along.
Yep. I need to scooch up.
Okay.
How do I...
Nope, should be just another apartment.
I think this was just open.
Yeah, I think that might be for another side quest. Also just open. Do people not lock their doors on the north side?
I guess they don't.
It's the party.
That's the party. So I need to... Is that the one that I need to go to? No, I have to keep going.
You want to go into the party.
Oh, I want to go
done.
In.
yeah, talk to the woman in the party.
Hey, you made it. I was beginning to wonder if you were going to show. The party's in full swing. Come on in. You have to try this.
Now, this is where I would drug the entire party.
This planet ages ago.
But you went the boring route.
That wine's got quite the kick.
Shh, okay.
We'll all be passed out on the floor.
Who cares? We're not on duty tomorrow. Let's live a little. Come on, drink up.
Get everyone drunk.
You need to equip it on either you or Karf. You only need the one set. There is a way to get a second set, but you don't need it. And I don't remember how to do it. Equipment. Just equip it in your clothing slot.
That's Karth. Wait.
I'm here.
Karth.
With armor at the bottom. Yeah.
Oh my god.
You only have one character model for it.
I look badass.
You do. It is a big improvement over Stormtrooper armor. It is shiny.
I just don't know where I'm going here.
Yes, what's on your mind? Terrace?
Basically, Karth was just too far away for you to leave. The game does that. It can be rather annoying.
That's all I can think of. You got it.
Oh.
Shots. I look so dumb. So dumb.
Don't diss the Sith Warrior armor. Not the Sith Warrior, the Sith Soldier armor.
I am
Sith Warriors are a different thing.
I am dissing
it. Wait until you see the red variant. It is beautiful.
I was itching my nose. Get out of the way, fuckers.
Don't spoil it, Galaxy. Yeah, you're in the lower city now, where the poor people live.
Puer.
We'll teach you who's the strongest. Stab, stab, stab.
Kipuna Kavatumpa.
You can take the armor off now if you want. Yeah. I like to continue wearing it though.
I've said this a few times. I'm assuming the canteen.
If you want.
If I want.
There are two party members to pick up here. Hi there. No, I'm just gonna. Okay.
Do you want to read?
You want me to?
Yes!
But nobody up there carries these kinds of Pizaka cards I sell. Are you interested in purchasing some individual cards to bolster your Pizaka deck? I'm talking about Pizaka. You know, the high-stakes gambling. Each player brings their own deck to a Pizaka match, and the better your cards are, the better your chances are winning.
Wasn't this guy selling other goods?
It's the same character model, but it's a different guy. I haven't even been able to restock my infantry since the Sith quarantine started, but I've still got a pretty good selection.
They each cost $200. Fuck off!
The bizarre life.
Go away.
We're gonna help this bounty hunter. I have a feeling we are.
One.
Oscar!
One? What's that mean? You be funny, tough guy. You know who we are, Kalo. We're the members of the Black Volcar Gang. You don't want to be getting funny with us, tough guy. Me no understand. One, two, why he can't. He trying to count how many of us is against him.
I don't think that's the case.
It's three against one, Kalo. What do you think about those odds? Well, you have something more to say?
After you?
Go away. One. Two. Smart.
Jesus. I get shit off of him. Could I have gotten him as a fun?
Huh? What?
You did get him as a side quest, yes. See you there.
Don't worry, honey. Alien girls aren't really my thing. I'm much more interested in an attractive female of my own species. You hear about that? I guess Zax must have mentioned me to you at the bounty office. Fair enough. I don't care who takes her out. Just so long as the job gets done. I can't let her get away with what she did. That wench tried to cut me with her vibro blade. Because she's crazy. She started screaming that I was making advances, and the next thing I know, she's coming at me with a knife.
Yeah, right. Sounds to me like she was defending herself.
I admit I was drunk. Maybe I got a little fresh. But it was no big deal. She didn't have to cut me.
Oh! Thank you, Tree! Thank you for raiding with the party! Hello, hello, hello to the two raiding. I'm assuming it's Tree and Puka. That's who I assume it is.
Is the host of the raid counted in the number?
No. Ah, there's the Pooka. There's Lord Goose.
Me.
The Lord of the Gooses. I'm gonna say I want the bounty removed.
What? I can't do that. Think how it would look. I work for Davik. I've got a certain reputation to uphold. I can't let her get away with this. There has to be payback. Although, I do feel a little guilty about all this. Dia's a good-looking gal. It'd be a shame to kill her. Tell you what, I'll take 200 credits in exchange for lifting the bounty. Well, I guess you may be right. Besides, I've noticed some of the girls around here are giving me the cold shoulder.
Hello, Tree. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Okay. You win. Dia can
good night,
live.
Pooka.
Good night,
wonderful
Pooka.
Dreams.
I'll go tell Zax right now that the bounty is off the table.
Oh, I did it.
Late save points. Yay.
Yay. I was able to figure out how to do- Oh, am I gonna have to stop a sexual thing?
I told you to leave me alone. So give me some space, bug eye. Your breath smells like Bantha Poodoo.
Kuyami, Juski, Chika Nai. Tong Patoga Smaktilia. The beast, you bone, kooky, punkpa. Tongi Twamaji, human act in Ikatune.
Who you call a little girl, Chuba Face?
Kuba Batu Konchi. She's got a soki, Kupa Bona na Chachu.
Just God, a sec, boys. Solbar, a little help here? I need you to rip the legs off some insects. Quit complaining. You can finish eating later. Besides, you need the exercise, so get over here.
Do I get these two people? Do I get a... What? I want a Wookiee.
You got a problem with me? Then you got a problem with Big Z. So unless you want to take on my furry friend, I suggest you greenies hop on out.
You do, but not right away.
I'm gonna go talk to her.
Say, I don't recognize you, and I know pretty much everyone in the lower city. You must be new down here. I guess that makes me and Big Z your official welcoming committee.
Zalbar is a mood. Zalbar is a mood. The best Wookiee.
Most aliens can speak basic, they just prefer to use their own language. But I grew up here on Terra, so I just sort of got used to speaking the native tongue.
You showed a lot of guts dealing with those Valkyrs, kid. You got a name?
My name's Mission Veo, and this big Wookiee is my best
Mission
friend.
Mission Veo.
I'd offer to give you a tour, but the streets down here aren't safe. But if there's anything else you need...
I don't want to ask that question!
We just kind of fell in together. It ain't easy on your own here.
Just kind of cute.
Everyone's always looking to push you around.
So we noticed. Still,
you
seem
see
like
a tree.
When I met up with Zalbar, it seemed like a pretty good match. I knew we could look out for each other. With my street smarts and his muscle, we make a great team. You going? Yeah, this dive is pretty boring. No action around here. Come on, Big Z, let's go.
I have finished eating. Oh my god. It's Lilia and
we'll
Durak.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
So does that make you I have to be myself. That's Nestaria.
Currently going for the entire
So are you
okay,
Karth? Technically?
Technically, Karmer can be HK-47.
Oh my god, it's the whole team!
No, we still need Nestaria.
This is Nestaria.
Oh yeah, duh. I'm an idiot.
Yeah, I am myself.
I forgot.
I is myself. That's hilarious. We unironically built ourselves.
Well, we didn't build ourselves. The game did.
Am I supposed to go here?
Hey, you can't just walk in here. This is the hidden back base. How do I know you're not a Volker spy sent to kill Gaddon Thek? A lot of people want to go inside and speak to Gaddon. He's a hero of the common folk. But the days of the Hidden Beck's open door policy are gone. Between the Sith conquest and the Volker gang war, Gaddon has more enemies than he used to. We're being careful about who we let in
fuck.
Now. My loyalty's not for sale. I've been with the Hidden Becks for years, and I'm not.
The DC is high.
Everyone is. It is a very high DC.
Well, we do need all the help we can get. And you don't look like you're with the Vulkers or the Sith.
No, I'm not with neither. If anything, I'm against them.
In the heart of his own base, not with Zerdra watching his back. Go in and speak to Gaddon if you want. Just remember to be on your best behavior. The Hidden Becks are watching you.
The Hidden Becks are watching you.
Thank you. Not scared at all. Gaddon! Gabby Gab.
Hold it right there. Who are you, and what is your business with Gaddon?
Calm down, Zerdra. Nobody's going to try anything here in the middle of our own base. It would be a suicide mission.
You're too trusting, Gaddon. Brezhik and his Volkers want you dead. Anyone we don't know is a potential threat, and it's my job to make sure you're safe.
Do you want us to start attacking strangers on sight, Zerdra? Like the Volkers do? I will never let it come to that. I'll step aside and let them pass.
As you wish. You can speak to Gaddon if you want, but I've got my eye on you. You try anything and you'll be vaporized.
Me holding
before
both
you can
my
say
thistles.
Volker spy.
Why can't I speak
to him? You'll
have
there to forgive Zerdra. Ever since Brezhik and the Volkers began this war against us, she's been a little overzealous in her security duties. The problems with the Sith haven't helped things. Zerdra seems to forget that I know how to look after myself. Now, how can I help you?
Any information on those Republic escape pods that crashed?
The escape pods? You know, I heard the Sith have been asking around the upper city about them as well. But you don't look like you're with the Sith.
They might be spies, Gaddon. They might be working for the Sith.
Calm down, Zerdra.
I'm not.
If the Sith
I'm against the Sith.
Useful,
Gaddon has a brain cell.
He's the one with the brain cell.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say, don't worry. I'm not working.
I suppose I could tell you what I know. It's not like it could do any harm to me or my gang. But it might cause problems for the Vulkers. And that's okay in my book. The Vulkers stripped those pods clean.
He has a piercing.
It's too bad we didn't get there first, considering what my spies reported the Vulkers found. A female Republic officer named Bastila survived the crash. We Becks don't believe in intergalactic slavery, but the Vulkers aren't so picky. They took a prisoner. Normally, the Vulkers would take a captured slave and sell them for a nice profit to Davik, or an off-world slaver. But a Republic officer is no ordinary catch.
I still think Bastila's just a Republic officer. That could work to our advantage. Maybe she'll even figure out a way to escape from the Vulker base on her own.
She's too valuable to leave with the Vulker scum at the base. Brezhik's probably got your Republic friend hidden away somewhere safe until the big swoop race. You'll never find
her. Now this is pod racing.
No! 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 No!
I'm afraid your friend has become a pawn in Brezhik's game to take over the lower city. He's offered her up as the Vulkers' share of the prize in the annual swoop gang race. By putting up such a valuable prize, Brezhik hopes to win the loyalty of some of the smaller gangs. Their numbers will allow him to finally destroy me and my followers.
So how do you propose we go about rescuing Bastila then? Well, we can't fight all the gangs.
The only hope you have of rescuing Bastila is to somehow win the big season opener of the swoop race.
So I have to win the race.
You have to win the race.
Whipped cream all over me.
Now this is pod racing.
Can I say how much I despise that?
Emotional damage!
I might be able to help you with this. If you'd be willing to help us. We both have something to gain here, and much to lose. The swoop race is for the lower city gangs only. I could sponsor you as a rider for the Hiddenbecks this year. If you win the race, you'll win your friend's freedom. But first, you have to do something for me. My mechanics have developed an accelerator for a swoop engine. A bike with the accelerator installed can beat any other swoop out there. But the Vulkers stole the prototype from us. They plan to use it to guarantee a victory in this year's swoop race. I need you to break into their base and steal it back.
Of course they stole it. Because why not out? What?
Getting into the Vulcan base won't be easy. The front doors are locked tight. But I know someone who might be able to get you in the back way. Mission Veo.
Mission? Gaddon, you can't be serious. She's just a kid. How is she supposed to help them with this?
Mission's explored every step of every back alley in the lower city. Plus, she knows the undercity sewers better than anyone. If anyone can get inside the Vulcan base, it's her. She and her Wookiee friend Zalbar are always looking to stir up a little excitement. They like to go exploring in the Undercity, despite the dangers. Your best bet is to look for her in the Undercity, but you'll need some way past the Sith guard post at the elevator. A simple disguise might have worked on the upper city guard, but the security down here is much tougher. You'll need the proper papers to get past him. Luckily, my gang ambushed one of the Sith patrols headed down to the Undercity. They never made it. And their security papers fell into my hands. Since we're working together now, I suppose I could give them to you in exchange for your uniforms. With the security papers, you won't need a disguise anyway. Good choice. Thanks for the uniforms. You won't need them.
He doesn't
with the
let you keep the uniform
anyway.
No matter what.
Now, is there anything else I can do for you?
Cat is out.
Which is annoying because I like the uniform.
I suggest you hurry. The swoop race is coming up, and we want
my
you
cat
to
is out cold on my bed.
Aww.
Even calling to her, she's not listening. Oh, I have the hiccups. I need health. I had a moment of he had no clothes on.
Are you sure?
Did that happen or was
anyone... I don't think it happened. I don't think it happened. No.
I like briefly looked at it and I was just like huh?
I think your mind's in the gutter.
It might be. Yeah. I am bad.
You were simping for Karth.
Only slightly. He's cute, okay? I am probably seeing things. I like looked for a second. I was like, huh? Is he shirtless? Why is he fucking shirtless? I was so confused.
You've got to go even deeper into the city to find Mission because she left the cantina.
Great.
Perfect. Well, not the lowest level.
Oh.
There's a guy at the end of the hallway.
Yeah.
you like that?
You guys are behind with your payments. What do you you think just because you're in some gang, you don't have to give Davik his cut? Ah, so you want to play this the hard way? Okay.
Oh, a big gun.
Rana no prata don't know sercha. What on a woman mulira? Can you do by shark?
Oh, he's a Mandalorian. Okay.
Yeah, he is.
I knew you boys would see reason. Now get out of here.
Too bad.
You don't mind me spoiling the second game. He becomes Mandalore.
Better get this over to Davik. I'll call you if anyone else gets behind on their payments.
Mandalore the Preserver. You don't leave the poor people apartments.
I don't think I need them. God! Fuck.
Just lob a grenade at them. Car protecting you.
Car, be my human shield. You're not protecting me very well. So this is not where I'm supposed to be?
I don't remember. No, it's where you're supposed to be.
Okay.
There's a door.
Hold on there, civilian. Only those with official Sith business are allowed into the Undercity. Unless you've
got the proper
papers!
Turn around
and go back the way you came.
Papers, please.
Let me see. These look to approved. Be in order. Crawling with mutants, rackles they call them. If you see anything moving down there, shoot
first,
ask
questions
later.
Thank you, kind sir. So much. I've made it to the Undercity.
Yes.
Somehow.
I love the Undercity people.
You there! Upworlder! Anyone using this elevator has to pay the toll.
Yeah, this is our elevator. If you use it, you gotta give us something.
Are they from New York?
I leave this planet. Even the beggars are trying to shake us down.
5 credits!
Might as well be.
That's what it costs to use our elevator. 5 credits!
Only 5 credits?
Yeah. Credits, my brother! We have credits. Now we can buy food and medicine.
Hush! The others will hear us. They'll want our credits. We have to hide them.
Go on, you two. Get out of here. I'm sorry about that. Those two beggars give everyone in the village a bad name. We aren't all like that, you know. Most of us are good people.
I'm sure you are, miss. It's just too bad your little welcoming committee is here to give people a bad first impression.
My name is Nessie Adias.
My name
you?
Is Shalina. You're from the Upworld, aren't you? I've never seen it. I was born here in the Undercity. Is it as nice as they say up there?
Surface is a beautiful place.
I've never been to the surface, but sometimes I think I can see it in my dreams. The sun, the sky, the stars, it all sounds...
You can absolutely break her world by saying it's...
Yandar, it's the leader of our village, tells me I should spend more time trying to improve things down here.
I'm trying to be nice! Something I can never have. I want this guy! When I was
little, Wilco used to tell me stories of what it was like. Darth, I get it.
Rukio's the oldest man in the village. The kids call him Rukio Wrinkleskin, but he's a... I still like to listen to his tales about the promised... It's a story to make the children smile. Rukio believes in it, though. Sometimes I can almost believe it myself, but then I look around and see the ugly truth.
Shame that I know what happens to all of these people.
If you really want to know more about the Promised Land, you should speak to Rukio.
They all get killed, and then 10 years later, another game was released that elaborated that they all died slowly and horribly.
He's wandering around somewhere on the south side of the village. He doesn't move too far. He's hard on his bones. He's over 100 years old. The children laugh at him, and people think he's crazy because of his stories about the Promised Land, but he's really just a kind old man.
It looked like she only had one tooth.
It's that low polygon.
Oh, okay.
Low polygon.
If you ever need
anything,
or if you just feel like talking, come back and see me. I hardly ever
it's 2003. They can't the afford teeth.
Yes, what's on your mind? You got it.
Okay. So what are we down here for?
Find mission.
The what?
Mission Vale. To find Mission Vale.
You ain't from the village. You're from the upworld, ain't you? Yes. You've got credits, I bet.
Watch yourself. There's something slimy about this guy. I wouldn't trust him as far as I could throw him.
My name's Sagir. I run a little salvage shop here. You want to
Why
buy
does
something
this give me Khajiit vibes?
I got some good deals. Yeah, okay. You'll come back and see me if you want a deal.
Yeah. So, what are we trying to find?
Mission Vale, the Twi'lek girl.
Mission! Where are you, Bish?
You're not looking for her directly. You need to like, exit the city and the undercity village place.
Hurry, Hinda! Hurry! I can hear it coming!
He'll never make it. He's doomed. I told him he was a fool to leave the village.
He will make it. Run, Hinda! Run!
Open the gate! Quickly! There isn't much time!
I can't! The Rakkuls are too close!
The mutants will kill him if you don't open the gate!
And if I open the gate, they'll kill us all!
No! You can't do this! It isn't fair! Please, make him open the gate! Hindar will die if he doesn't!
I can't open the gate! Not while the Rakkuls are... You'd risk your life for a stranger?
Yep, I risk my life!
You're brave, Uplorber. I'll open the gate for you, but you gotta be quick.
Just try to
In a few
impress,
seconds,
Gar.
I must close and lock it again.
I know you.
I can't help it. Cute. No, he died! Motherfucker?
Yes, what's on your mind? You got it. Uh-huh.
for you to get a second companion and unlock the inter-party conversations.
So the guy died.
But you can leave now? Oh, you're already outside.
Hindar, no! Well, we tried. Oh, do I have to go out there?
Yeah, put you outside to fight the thing. Yeah, you need to go out there.
Please, you have to help me. Nobody else is going to help me. Even the Becks won't help me. But I can't just leave him there. He's my friend. You'll help me, won't you? It's Zalbar. He's in trouble. Big trouble. We have to help him. If we don't, they'll sell him into slavery. Me and Zalbar, we were just wandering around here in the Undercity. You know, looking for stuff we could find, just kind of exploring. We do it all the time.
I guess with a Wookiee at your side, you've got to figure you can handle the odd Rakghoul attack.
Only this time, they were waiting for us. Gamorrean slave hunters. We didn't even have a chance to run. Big Z threw himself at him and then roared for me to run. I took off. I figured Zalbar would be right behind me. But there were too many of them. He couldn't get away. They're going to sell him
dumb
to a slaver.
Now we have to go fucking save your Wookiee.
I don't know for sure, but those Gamorreans like to hang out in the sewers. The stink reminds them of home, I guess. That's probably where they took Big Z. No way. I'm the one that got Zalbar into this mess, so I'm coming with you. I'm not going to abandon him again.
You can have more than one party member with you.
I know.
I don't know for sure. It's a deal. As soon as we get Big Z back, I'll show you a way into that Volker base. Now come on. We have to find Zalbar before
I was trying to be nice.
Or worse.
Do you know where he's being kept?
The Gamorreans make their camps in the sewers. I bet...
Yay, I got two party members.
Wait for them to start talking to each other. No, don't just wait, just go about and they'll do it eventually. The red one, yes.
This is a restricted area. What are you doing down here? One patrol. We figure the Rakghouls got them. We've had so many encounters with those things, we've actually run out of Rakghoul serum. Plus, we've had several skirmishes with looters from those lower city swoop gangs. I'm telling you, we should just stay in the upper city where we're in control.
Said you lost one patrol,
right?
Why are
you down here? Search and rescue. I didn't think they'd send anyone. They were in the southern section of the Undercity when we lost contact. I would have gone to investigate, but my orders are to search for those crashed escape pods, even if it means leaving another patrol to die.
I can't remember if there's stuff at that lost patrol or not, but...
We gotta go. Rackle.
Take that. Die already.
Ooh, level up.
Level up again. Ooh, we get to increase our attribution. I think I'm gonna go Constitution. Yeah.
4 points. So certain ones that lie within your class cost 1 point, and then the other ones take 2.
Yeah. There we go.
Works.
Yeah.
You'll find where you need to go eventually. Grenade.
Ready?
Yeah?
It almost killed one of them.
Time to rumble.
I die.
You'll pay. You'll pay.
A quick
kill her! Oh my god!
Run! Ah. This might be a good time to remind you to save often.
Shut up!
You there!
Yeah, there.
Fuck! Go on, you two! Get out of here! I'm sorry. My name. Genda. He'll be some. I don't know anything about that.
Also, in combat, you can use the pause thingy to plan out the next few attacks for all of your party.
Wait, Upworlder. You can't go through this
it
gate.
It really helps
there is
the combat.
Farewell.
Please, help us. We're... No! This cannot be... No!
Oh no. They were infected. Are you trying to do? Go back. L pause, not that pause.
Yeah, I'm trying to get health.
Yeah, go back. Go back. It's in the menu where whoa. Can you use it like that?
Yeah.
That's it. Rack ghouls are annoying.
Annoying is an understatement.
It's an... I don't know what that is. That's not there for the PC version. Ooh. May want to hide that before...
Yeah.
Oh, load game.
10 minutes to 3 hours.
Fair enough. Fair enough.
I think I'll call it.
Yeah.
Two deaths in a row, and I'm just like.
I'll Fuck get off. You to finish the game.
You will. You will. You will. We will continue this. This will be our ongoing game. That will stream until we finish. Does that make you happier?
Yes. Yes, it does.
Why am I getting spammed?
I don't know. Where are you getting spammed?
I don't know. Everywhere is the answer. Okay. Have a wonderful day, guys. Stay safe. All that jazz. Ugh. I died too many times. I'm sad.
Bye.
Yeah. Bye, everyone!